Hello, hello, my darlings. I hope you're doing great. So today we are gonna talk about my current favorite easy reaches, so to speak, because these are the fragrances that I have been reaching for the most the past month. Quite a nice selection of very affordable and very bougie slash niche fragrances, so I hope you're gonna enjoy. And before we do that, please don't forget to subscribe and of course follow me on Insta. I've been doing a lot of different things on Instagram for the past month, so if you're interested, go check me out there. And now let's just jump in. I don't want to make it too long of a video. So the first one is actually quite a surprise for me because it usually used to be my going out fragrance, date night fragrance, but these days it's been very cold and it's been snowing and it makes me feel very cozy yet very sexy. And I've been wearing it on a daily basis. Like, you know, when I'm getting ready in the morning, I spray this one, and that is Montale Intense Cafe. And maybe it also is because I have two bottles of it and I'm kind of trying to use up one of them, you know, because I am still on planning to buy the Ristretto version, so I don't want to have three Intense Cafe bottles, if you know what I mean. So I've been using this one up. I think I'm halfway through, and I really, really love this fragrance. This is definitely one of the best Montals and the best introductory niche fragrance. If you are on the fence what niche fragrance to buy first, I think this one is perfect if you love very sweet fragrances. If you don't know already, I'm sure you do though. This is a coffee, vanilla, and rose fragrance. It kind of smells like very over sugared latte, but it's beautiful. I really love it. It does mix well with other fragrances such as Baccarat Rouge or some other vanillas. You can add some woody notes to it and you're gonna have a very nice concoction. So yes, Intense Cafe by Montale, it lasts all day, it projects like crazy, so I get loads of compliments with this one. So that's my first one that I've been wearing very often day to day. The next one is actually a new one, and I did not do any haul recently, mainly because I didn't really buy any new fragrances. I have been trying to get rid of some before I go ahead and purchase new ones. That's my kind of a New Year resolution. So yeah, as soon as I get rid of or sell or give away the fragrances that I intend to, then I will be able to buy new ones for you guys for my reviews and stuff. But this one I could not resist, and because I got a sample of it, I was able to test it before I bought it, and I'm really in love. And that is Juliet Hexagon Pear Incorporated, and this one of course has pear in it. Ambroxan masks, it is so pretty. It is slightly in the vibe of God Is a Woman by Ariana Grande, but definitely less sweet. It's a fresh fragrance. It is still sweet, don't get me wrong. It has some nice depth to it as well, but it's not as juvenile, so to speak, as Ariana Grande is. This one is a little bit more like a little shelf higher, you know what I mean? It lasts well, I must say. I did spray it on my jacket, and after a week or two, I can still smell it, which is great. So even though it's a lighter fragrance and Juliet Hexagon is not really known to last for ages, this one is actually very, very good. When it comes to longevity on the skin, it's worse, but on the clothing and on the hair, it's absolutely fantastic. So yes, this one I have been wearing so much, even though I haven't really put much dent in it. But trust me when I say I am in love with this one. This is so, so pretty, gorgeous everyday fragrance. I think it's gonna work absolutely perfectly in hotter weather And even though it's fresher, I really like wearing it when it's cold outside. It just gives me that nice boost of energy, so to speak. So yes, I really like it, and I will be surely doing a big haul of Juliet Has a Gun, because I have a lot of fragrances of theirs in my basket online. So you can expect a nice Juliet Has a Gun haul and review. But for now, I highly recommend this one. This is their new release, Pear Incorporated. Very nice one. Okay, now when it comes to cheapies, I have quite a few. First one that I've been reaching for so much, and I'm a little bit surprised because I recently bought Givenchy L'Entardy and L'Entardy Intense, and even though I have been grabbing this one for some reason, and that is Zara Sublime Epoque. And this is very similar. It's also in the vibes of Giorgio Armani My Way. You know, it's that sweet tuberose with some greenness to it, with slight fruitiness to it. It's very nice, very sweet, uplifting. It lasts very nicely on my skin and on my clothes, so I cannot really say anything bad about it. If you are on a fence when it comes to My Way by Giorgio Armani or L'Entardy, I think if you are on a budget, you're gonna be perfectly fine with this one. It really does smell expensive, it smells sophisticated, so massive thumbs up from that. So yeah, Sublime Epoque, very, very nice fragrance. Cheerful, pretty, feminine, everything that I sometimes need. So yeah. All right, completely different spectrum of things here. Very, very unisex one. And I love it. I really, really love it. I bought two from the brand, and this one just took the cake for me. And this is Eccentric O2 from Eccentric Molecules. And this one is supposed to have, of course, ambroxan, but it also has some other notes such as iris. I do smell some citrusy touches in here as well, because this is quite a fresh fragrance, and iris here, if it actually is here, it smells completely non-irisy, if it makes sense. To me, it just smells so amazing, so sexy, so sensual. It's so gorgeous, guys. I don't know what it is about it, but yes, there is slight powderiness, but not like this, you know, old lady, so to speak, powderiness. It's not that typical irisy lipsticky scent. It is still there, but it's done so well. I just cannot, and it lasts beautifully. It doesn't have the strongest projection, but you know, when I just get out of the shower, or when I go to bed, or when I'm just hanging around the house, I love wearing this. Even running errands, it doesn't matter. I just love wearing it all day, all around, every day. And I did actually dent it quite nicely this month. So yeah, very, very pretty fragrance. If you love those unisex fragrances, you're gonna absolutely love it. If you don't have it already, what are you doing? I know not everybody is a fan of ambroxan. I personally adore ambroxan. I don't know why. To me, it's just slightly ambery, slightly sweet, salty, slightly like marine type of scent, but mixed with other ingredients, it just is magic. So yeah, Eccentric Molecules O2, fantastic one. Of course, everything will be linked below as per usual. Okay, next one that I've been wearing so much, and it's another cheapie, and you guys know I've been wearing it because every time I do like my favorites video or something, I showcase it. It's really hard to get. I will of course link it below, but it's really hard to get for some reason. I don't know why. This is Jill Zander, and this is the newest release for last year, and this is Sun Parfum. So as you can see, it has like a very orange cap. And this one is Honey Musky Bomb. It does have some tropical flowers. And it is just so beautiful. I cannot. I wouldn't say it's particularly like straight up summer fragrance. To me, it's a very sweet, strong fragrance. Even though it's just Jill Zander, it doesn't last. It projects. It's just so pretty. And I love wearing it for every day, you know. To me, it's a little bit too strong to wear to bed. But when I go out running errands, doing my thing, you know, grocery shopping and stuff, I love wearing this one. This is so good. It's so feminine, very, very honey-based. But maybe if Jean Paul Gaultier Scandale Honey you find annoying, I think you still might love this one because it's done quite differently. I love this fragrance. I don't really love their bottles, I'm not gonna lie. They don't look gorgeous on the counter whatsoever. So I kind of keep it away. I keep it either like in a drawer or in the bathroom, I'm not gonna lie. But I still really, really love it. So yes, it's long lasting, it's inexpensive, try it, it's so nice. So that's Saint Parfum. Then the next fragrance that I'm trying to use up, because I'm slowly getting ready to purchase the intense version that I'm praying it's gonna be available in Poland eventually, because it's been years, like, to me, and I've been waiting and waiting, and I feel like it's never gonna come to Poland. But enough rambling. I've been using Cloud from Ariana. This is such a nice, easy fragrance. I don't want to use Baccarat on a daily basis simply because I know that soon I will be traveling a lot. I will be attending a lot of formal events. So I just, you know, it's a stingy bitch inside me and I just don't want to use it up. I want to keep it for those special occasions because I know myself and I know that when those occasions come, and they're going to come very, very soon, I will be just showering myself with Baccarat Rouge. So I really do need my 200 ml bottle. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. You know how I am when it comes to overspraying. So these days, if I really feel like Baccarat, I usually use Cloud. It's very inoffensive. It's not like a massive boost of projection and scent bubble. To me, it does last decent, but it's not like, you know, it's not suffocating me. So it's good when I'm working at home or, again, running my errands. But in general, this has a Baccarat Rouge vibe with some praline and with some coconut. So I do really love it. I love some coconut, you know that, guys. So yeah, a very, very nice one. I have been also using the Red Temptation from Zara, which is Baccarat equivalent, but I think that I have been reaching for Cloud more. So that's why it's here. So that's the one. Another one that I have been using a ton these days, and not this particular bottle, because I have two bottles, one of which is in my mom's house, in my room, and I've been using that one. I just keep it there. And when I sleep at my mom's, I use it every time. I don't bring anything with me. And that is La Belle by Jean Paul Gaultier, one of my favorite scents. I know that so many of you love it, but some of you find it completely not interesting. And you're not scared to tell me that, but that's okay. Because I love it and I don't care. This to me is a beautiful pear vanilla fragrance with some vetiver to it. So this is like a dense vanilla pear. And Pear Incorporated is like your fresh, musky pear. So two pear fragrances in here. Apparently, I do have a vibe these days. I do love my pear. Probably I will even buy God as a Woman because I like that pear as well. So yeah, La Belle, long-lasting projects. That's why I have it in my mom's house, because I usually, you know, run errands when I'm at her place, because she lives in a city center and I just need to have something absolutely foolproof. So that's why I keep it there. So yes, La Belle, absolutely fantastic one. You guys know I love it. And last one, but definitely not least, we have Bois Doré from Van Cleef & Arpels. And I think It's actually the most expensive fragrance that I have here. So as you can see, guys, the past month I have been very, very budget friendly. So yes, Bois Doré is so, so beautiful. It is a almondy, tobacco, vanilla, kind of smells like vanilla ice cream, but like the real vanilla based ice cream with some fresh tobacco. Very, very pretty. It is also slightly salty thanks to those mineral notes that are in there. But in general, the combination is so, so pretty. One of the best Van Cleef fragrances and one that does last so, so well. It lasts all day on your clothes, on your skin. Very good purchase if you have a few bags to spare. I think investing in Bois Doré is a fantastic choice because you are definitely getting what you are paying for, because it does last. Unlike Orchid Vanille from Van Cleef, that one is not the best on longevity, but this one really, really is. So, beautiful one. I'm not saying Orchid Vanille is bad because it's a beautiful vanilla, but I'm a little bit put off because of very bad longevity. And this one, it has a great longevity. So, thumbs up. Bois Doré, absolutely beautiful. And that is it, my lovelies. Please tell me in the comments below. By the way, I'm very sorry for that cracking, glass cracking sound. I just have my basket here and I moved it. So yeah, thank you so, so much for watching. Please tell me in the comments below what were your favorite fragrances of the month. These are definitely the ones that have been using on rotation, and now I am planning to switch them up a little bit. Now that I know for sure which one I've been using the most, I'm gonna, you know, switch my whole thing just to use my fragrances. So yeah, tell me which ones have been your favorites, and see you in my next one. Bye.